Welcome back to another must-known basics for Game Maker Studio, and I skimmed over a little thing which is called variable definitions, and for that I made a little thingy here, so a little project, so you can check it out. And then boom, once upon pressing this little button, only a specific instance is being active, and then it's spawning. So basically my object spawn, and for example on this one, just this specific one. And there are different kind of approaches how you can utilize the variable definition, the creation code, and the regular stuff, and I'm gonna show you how to do this. So basically this video will be a general thing about the creation code, the, what is that thing called again, the variable definitions, and the regular create event. So this is this dude here. So if you want to know more, stay tuned. This is OneUp Indie. I am a developer. So if you like what you're seeing, hey, why not consider sharing, liking, and subscribing? Alrighty, so let's jump quickly into that thing. So to give this a little bit confusion, a very cohesive thing. So normally what you would be doing is, for example, you create your object. Then you say like events, let's do something with it. And then for example, you go into the create event and say speed. Let's give it a value of 1. And for example, once we set this little ball into the room, let's make this bigger, come on. And then for example, we're having 2. And now what you would be expecting, both go in the same direction. This is no new stuff for you. But let's say you double click on here and then you got a creation code. And then would you say, nah, 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 my friend, let's go speed -1, haha. And then for example, what you will see now is that both balls go in an opposite direction, because this is the default one and this one goes to the left side. So this is what the creation code is good for. For example, upon creation, you can say like, ooh, I want to change something, I want to adapt something, let's do this. And then for example, you can give it different kind of a code upon creation. That's why it's called creation code. But just keep in mind that the creation code comes after the regular create code. So for example, if you have a value here, then if you do the creation code, which is in here, then this value, for example, if you say like, hey, the speed value, I want to override it, then you just say speed -1 or -2, whatever, then you override the initial one. And then we come to a thing, which is this dude here, variable definition. If you open it up, if you open it up, normally it is empty. And then you say like, okay, this is pretty useless. And I don't know, it is actually quite useful in a few regards. So first thing, what you can do, you can create your own variables also. And one thing which you need to understand, that we now have a hierarchy. So first of all, the variable definitions are coming first, then you have your regular create event, which is this dude here, so upon events and then create, and then the last thing which is coming in kind of the hierarchy of overwriting each other, then you got the instance creation code, which is this dude, double click over here. So you see there is kind of a hierarchy, and what you can do with all these three events is create variables. So let's say for example you say like, give it a variable in this dude here, then GameMaker Studio will create a variable with the name of goodness, and then you can basically have a step event and say like, let's move my x plus equals goodness, and this will actually work even though for example this variable hasn't been created beforehand. So let's go and delete that thing, delete this dude, and for example once we start it, nothing happens. And nothing happens, why? Because you need to give it a value. Whoa, beginner mistake once again. And now we're moving to the right, rookie mistake, from my side. As you can see, there are different kind of ways how to do the same thing. But if you're thinking like, okay, so that thing is completely useless. No, it definitely has some uses. So first of all, you can create your own variables and then you set up a default variable. And then, for example, you can actually set it to an integer, string, boolean, whatever, blah, 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 even an asset. So basically you are saving, let's say, the ID of, let's say, for example, of an object. which isn't too bad. For example, you can change that. But let's go for the real one. And here you even got for each type you got, for example, you can actually use a range. And now, you can actually play around with that. And you can go between 0 and 10, or I don't know, 0 and 20, doesn't really matter. And then, for example, 10 is the default. And now upon, for example, double clicking on the ball, you got here variables. And before that, it was empty and like, oh, now you got a variable. You can click on this dude here. And now you can actually do this and set it to a new value. And this is, for example, how you can reset your ball with this stuff also. But for example, you can actually, I don't know, use speed and then set it to 1. So you can use the eternal ones, the internal ones, or for example, you can create your own ones if you like. So here, once again, you can play around with that. And then, for example, you can modify it. So this is a pretty cool thing. And if you're thinking, I'm not convinced, what is this actually good for? Because I can just do this in my create event and then I'm pretty much done. Or you can use my create event and then the creation code, which is overriding that. Yes, but here, this approach is pretty sweet. For example, if you have a little team, and then for example, one is basically not the coder, that he doesn't know where all this stuff is, and you just point him, hey, let's click on variables, and then boom, he can set up the values with sliders and just input them in here. So this is a nice way how to reuse a system of, basically this is just an additional system how to change a few things. So one thing, for example, you can actually use it for, and this is a little bit more meaningful because the basic stuff, I guess, hopefully I'm not boring you too much. What you can do is use the creation code, the variable definition. I'm sorry, because I'm not using that stuff at all from my side. For example, what you can do is, and this is what I did here, just declare instance variable, say like, hey, it's undefined at the very beginning, so there's nothing. And then what we can actually do is double click on this dude, grab the instance ID. And this one is always changing. So for example, if you delete it, so as you can see, it's FD2. Let's get rid of that. And for example, wants to place a new one and double click. Oh, it has a different one. So as you can see, the instance IDs, which are unique, are being generated randomly. So here, once again, just a little thing, if you just delete or create new ones, just be aware of that. So for example, we can just take this one, go into our variables, then say like, ooh, change it to this one. And now we have saved the instance which we want to target. So this is this instance. And then for example, upon hovering over, we activate that thing just quickly so you can actually see the code. So basically we just have a little variable which is called active. And then we are looping through our alarm. So every 60 seconds. And then for example, if this active variable is set to true, we are creating a spawn which is falling down, and the spawn code is just speed direction falling downwards. And then, well, at some point we are deleting it because, hey, we don't need it. So this is the code, very, very quickly shown. And then, for example, I guess the more interesting part is, how is the button structured beside this little instance variable? As you can see, no create event here. We just have a step event. And then at the very beginning, we are saying like, hey, is the default value, which is undefined, is it not undefined? So we actually assigned our little button here, one of those spawners here. Then we just say like, hey, if on the position meeting, so this is returning a true value, so 0 or 1. And for example, if it's returning 1, hey, on this instance, because this one we actually have saved, set this one to active, and well, then it is pretty much done. And for example, we say like, okay, we are not hovering with our mouse X and Y over ourselves, so over the button here, this dude here. Then we say like, else image index 0. So this is just indicating like, hey, 0 or 1. So very, very quickly. So you can see this, this is 0, this is 1. So you can see, it's pressed or not pressed. And then we just say like, hey, this thing which we are targeting, the instance of the spawner, it's not active, so don't spawn stuff in there. And for example, we can actually put a second one in there, say like, cool, creation code we don't use, variables, okay, default one, it's undefined, so we just say like, hey, let's take this guy here and override it. and now we have a two button system which you can use for puzzles, for doors, for hidden things or stuff you want to activate. As you can see now, we are activating here because they are linked, and here we are activating this one because these guys are linked. And the old approach, which I did beforehand, so this is what I did in other tutorials, is another way how you can do this. You can just have a little variable which you called linked ID. As you can see, once again, this variable hasn't been declared anywhere, but it has. What I do, I just said like, hey, creation code, linked ID. Sorry, I cannot do this bigger, so we set it to a value of 2. And then the same variable which we use for the button thingy here, linked ID 2. And then, for example, both have now a variable inside which has the value of 2 and has basically the same name. And then we're just saying like, hey, once again, position meeting. And then, for example, we just say like, hey, with object spawner. So basically we are going through all the instances of all spawners. So this is a little bit clunky because we're going through sometimes quite a few, a lot of objects, which are, well, all the instances of object spawner. And then we're just saying like, hey, is there in, well, a linked ID which has the value, and then, for example, a self, which is from this dude here. And because they have the same value, we set it to active. And just little thing, if you use with just means everything which is inside all the instances of the object spawner. And there we have a little inside there, we have a variable which is called active. And then we got the negative version. We just go through all the object spawners once again. So like, have we not? Boom, set it to false. And this is, for example, the same stuff for creation code, or rather instance creation code. So once again, we hold over and then we are spawning. We are not spawning. And then, of course, here we can target those things. Hopefully that made sense to you. So basically, just the hierarchy. Once again, you have your variable definitions, number one. You have your creation code, number two. And then you have your completely biggest dude in the room, which is your creation code, which is then number three in the hierarchy. And for example, once the, in quotations, the creation is done, so basically we got all the variables which we want to use, then we are jumping into the step event, and then we can actually use those things which we declared in one of these three. We could call it events, because I guess they are technically events, but they just use it in a different way. But okay, that was pretty much it from my side. Hopefully now you understand how to use them. Well, the creation code, the variable definitions, and the instance creation code. Wow, everything sounds the same. It pretty much is. But that's life. Alrighty, that was it from my side. Have a good one. One up, Indie.